Up for review today, we have a limited edition Amen release, and it's called Pure Coffee. Pure Coffee was released in 2008 as a limited edition flanker to Angelmen. Here's the bottle. As you can see from this bottle, the star actually covers up how much juice you have, so you never really know. I'm gonna throw up the box right now. And as you can see from that box, a lot of people talk about, like, somewhere in the middle of the box, there's a little scent thing. Just like on coffee bags, before you buy them, you could have squeezed the package and got the scent. Now, I just tried to film this review, and that's why it might come off a bit rushed. I'm trying my hardest not to. And you might see me look down at the ticker every now and then because it, like, cut me off after 50 seconds and I had, like, 12 minutes worth of video, so sorry about that, guys. Basically, let me spray this on and we'll go ahead and look through the fragrance. I've been putting one on the hand now for closer examination. The start of this fragrance is very strange. There's something green going on, something... don't know how to explain it, something gross, but it's intriguing and addicting. The opening to this fragrance is ridiculous. I love the opening, but it's weird and freaky. And to inexperienced noses, you're gonna smell that opening, especially if you bought this for $300, and get really, really pissed off. But trust me, the opening is not what it's all about. Let's go ahead and go over the bottle while this is resting. On the bottom, we have this is kind of cool. It actually says Angelmen on the bottom, Angelmen Pure Coffee. The rest of the Pure line and current Angelmen bottles will just say Amen. So that's kind of cool. Got your number right there, and all the other info is down there. I went over a video about the sprayers. If you have a problem spraying it, sorry, I don't. It's not cut. I feel no need. Like I said, you're not going to be able to see how much juice you have, but I think that does look very cool, as opposed to the other Pure line bottles. The rubber on this one is actually sort of a green-brown. It's kind of cool. Yeah, sort of like a green-brown kind of coffee color. Rubber texture, of course. Back to the scent. After that burst of weirdness, it turns into a the weirdness you find out is a semi-sweet chocolate. There's vetiver and musk floating around in there. I'll get back into that in a few minutes, but overall you're gonna get this very smooth, rich vanilla coffee. It's not a Donna Karan Be Delicious Men coffee. It's not a coffee that you've smelled in any other fragrance. This coffee, I have a essential oil in my armoire. It's actually coffee cold compression CO2 extract, and it smells very similar to this. So I'm not sure what he used, but that ingredient is very expensive, and it wouldn't surprise me if he used some sort of CO2 extract of coffee in this fragrance. Comes off very dry. As I mentioned in my other video before it got cut off, it's extremely similar to Le Gâteau de Parfum. A lot of people will call Le Gâteau de Parfum, they'll call it pure chili, they'll call it taste of fragrance. Well, you know, it really could be called taste of fragrance, but I believe that Amen Le Gâteau de Parfum has a lot in common with this, and I think maybe when they started Le Gâteau de Parfum, they wanted it to be a flanker of this, but that doesn't really make sense to do a flanker of a limited edition, so they just didn't do that. They released it on its own. Alongside the fact that people call it pure chili, I can understand why. Pure malt. That really shouldn't have been named pure malt. It should have been named Amen Liqueur de Parfum, just like Alien Liqueur de Parfum and Angel Liqueur de Parfum. They've been doing this with their releases for a while, where they coincide the women's releases with their pure release. They did it with pure malt, the liqueur de parfum. They did it with the Legault de Parfum, and they also did it with Aqua Chic. And it's awkward because the Aqua Chics coincide with Pure Shot. My opinion, you all don't have to share it, it just makes sense to me. You see the Liqueur de Parfum, and then you see Angel and Alien come out at the same time. Now, Pure Havan didn't have one. And then you see Legault de Parfum, and you see Angel and Alien come out with the same thing. And then you see Pure Shot, and then you see Angel and Alien at this very same time come out with Aqua Chic. It just sort of makes sense in my head. Now back to Pure Coffee. It was the first of the line, the first of all the legend. Came in a flask. Smells like Amen a little bit, with the coffee amped up to about 20 on a scale of 10. It's, in my opinion, it's unwearable. It's a smell, it's not really a fragrance, but it's a good smell. Is it worth the price tag on eBay? Yes. Was it worth it when it was retail? Fuck yes. This thing is awesome. You guys that love coffee, you're going to want to wear this all the goddamn time. You're going to wake up, pour your coffee in your cup, you're going to get your shower, and then you're just going to spray this on and be happy all day. To you people that don't like coffee, turn this video off. Go ahead. It's right up there. Hit the X. Okay, now that I still have my people that like coffee or love coffee, throughout the day, you're going to get huge hits of just this chocolatey, vanilla, smooth, creamy coffee just hitting you in the face. It's not going to creep that far off your skin. Just remember that. But and that's kind of a downside, because you really don't want to wear this in the winter because it's not going to cut through that air. But if you're indoors, yeah, you can wear this. I would go about around 3 sprays. You're saying, Matt, why do you do only 3 sprays in this? Well, it's subtle, but it hits hard. And I think it coincides with the complexity of this scent. You're going to need to get your nose on this and be smelling it while I'm describing this in order to get, sort of an accurate depiction of what I'm talking about. But to you people that are looking to perhaps buy Pure Coffee, at the price range, I would say yes. $200, $150, go ahead and buy it. It's niche quality, of course. I think all of these fragrances have done a very good job, the Pure line, have done a very good job of getting away from the Amen, whereas Amen was just this sticky, sweet, sort of fougere-gourmand hybrid. All of these take a point from Amen and then bring everything around that point rather than everything being in there. Angel Men has all these components. It has the components of Pure Havan, Pure Shot. It has the components of Pure Malt, Pure Coffee, Legault de Parfum. They'll tell you this. They'll tell you it's all in there, but they exemplify certain things to make it what it is. And this one, with the exemplification of the coffee accord, is definitely a very good fragrance in my book. Personally, that's not my thing. So versatility, it gets like a 2. You're not going to want to smell like coffee everywhere you go. This is going to be for... You're going to want to know where you're going and why you're going there and who's going to be there and who doesn't like perfume and who likes coffee, who doesn't like coffee. Am I going to be drinking coffee while I'm there? Are people going to think that I smell like a foreigner? You got to worry about all those things when you're going out with this sort of fragrance. But to the person that doesn't care, fuck it, wear it. I don't care. I don't care what you do. I'm just giving recommendations. Longevity. This thing lasts all day, but it becomes very close after the first hour. Anyone who has experienced Pure Coffee knows that. I haven't had any instances of this jumping off skin. People are complimenting me left and right, but they do tell me that I smell nice. And I told my people at work, I said, don't tell me I smell nice unless it's something that you really like. And so they stopped telling me unless I wear something I like. So I tend to get honest compliments nowadays. This one, on a scale of compliments, I'd give it probably a 6 out of 10, as far as my job goes. So if people are looking for compliments, it's just more for your enjoyment. Bottles that are similar, in structure, I would say Cocorico. I'm just trying to look around at my shelves. In structure. Oddly enough, in structure, structurally wise, I would say CKB, just because it has sort of an effervescence about it. Not really. I mean, it has Amen smells to it. It has Amen vibes to it, but it's not really a. It's not really a child of Amen. It's more of a stepchild. So yeah, Pure Coffee by Thierry Mugler, a very good release, worth the money on eBay. Go pick yourself up a bottle. You'll smell like coffee, and you'll smell good. Remember, guys, Tony and I have a fragrance discussion group on Facebook. All you have to do is go on Facebook and type in fragrance discussion up in that little search bar, and you'll come right to our group. Or you can just click the link down below, and you can ask to join. One of us will almost instantaneously add you to it. What else do I want to say? You know, like and subscribe if you like our videos. Everything counts. You know, the little bit of money that we have been making has been going towards getting bottles for review, getting samples, you know, things like that. So the more people we have, the more better our channel will become. As horrible of English as I am.